for all those cultural heritage of our society. And who knows, sir, NRIs, other people, they want to hear in bowl songs, sir, they will download and some money will go back to these artists. So creating an entrepreneurial culture so that people must get out, they must select themselves out of this employment. They don't need it. They will become entrepreneurs in villages of our society, sir. We can use the railways. 20 million people travel by train every day, sir. 20 million people travel by train every day. If these messages will go to them, the challenges will go to them, we will turn around the mood of the society. Sir. So how to disseminate the ideas, how to source. And sir, the last element that we wanted to highlight here is in-situ value addition. We just had our Shodhyatra, 30th Shodhyatra in Manipur. I'm coming from Chulachandrapur. They have so much resources, not little value is added to that, sir. How can their wages go up? You know, sir, but no matter how compassionate we are, there's a limit to which we can increase the wages. But if we add value, there's no limit, sir, to what extent we can improve their livelihood. So in situ value addition, that means where the resource occurs, we have to add value there, not elsewhere. At least some value should be remaining. Then large part of the value chain will remain in that part. This is one of the goals that we will put to this student, sir. Just an example, sir. There's a virgin nature, and then there is this bridge, which you have in the non-Griyat village. In non-Griyat village in Chirapunji, they have made a living root bridge, sir. Living root bridge. We have walked on that bridge from taking the roots of the trees from two sides of the river, and they have joined it. It's a living bridge. This is the ultimate statement about sustainability, of how creative our people are, how sustainable they are, and to challenge, I mean, they can tell us more about sustainability than we can tell them, sir. So we would like that their knowledge and ideas are harnessed. This is another example, sir. Water is a very serious problem for our society. In Mizoram, almost every house has a rooftop water harvesting. Their sanitation standards are very high, and one can say that Mizoram, because Mizoram people were moved 30 years ago from the valleys to the mountains. At that time, they had abundant water. Now they had no water here. Every single house has a rooftop water harvesting. This kind of messages from different parts of the country will charge the mind, sir. This is the problem I was saying, sir, that we issue Inclusive Innovation Challenge Awards. And this year, again, in March, with your guidance, we'll issue 3 more challenges and invite the country to pose solutions so that these women cannot have to do that. With this biennial award that we have, this person, Rosa Deen, has converted a pressure cooker into a coffee-making machine. So you don't need a big device. In 450 rupees, he has generated additional livelihood for tea vendors. Now they also give espresso coffee. It's a large number of such points. So we call it mining the mind of the masses. And this is another innovation, sir. A non-stick pan just in about 60 rupees to 100 rupees by Mansukh Bhai Prajapati in a village. And he has designed the machines, all these machines he has designed to make these pans. There are a lot of pottery work in the rest of the country, sir. But they are not getting so much value from that pottery. People are not buying those things. We have to bring new products for these potters if we want their skill to be upgraded. These are the innovators who are generating these solutions. Similarly, sir, we want the multimedia, multi-language collaboration and innovation platform so that people work together. Sir, there's a lot of bamboo in Northeast. And these bamboo, they're practically very little value is added. Ralte in Mizoram has added a machine to make incense sticks. Parish Panchal in Gujarat has added, made an incense stick machine. In Manipur, we found there was a lot of scope for these. So we will be able to diffuse them, help people to improve their livelihood so that their incomes increase. There's a food processing machine in the center, sir, which Dharambir in Yamunanagar has developed. There are so much of fruit in Northeast goes waste because markets are not accessible. But when we add value and make those products, they will be accessible, sir. So army's requirement, defense requirement, our trains, canteens, they can start selling the juice of those fruits which are growing Northeast. We generate employment, sir. One of the reasons for insurgency is people have nothing to do and they're not finding much opportunity for using their talent. So this is the triangle that we make it happen. The transaction cost, both ex ante and ex post, of innovator, of entrepreneur, and of investor are very high, sir. Through these innovation clubs with various universities, we'll be able to reduce the transaction cost. These young people will find entrepreneur, they will find the investor, they will find, and the innovators. They will try to make this triangle in every university, sir. Every university will be forging this triangle to happen so that the inability of these three actors to come together is reduced. We want to have an entrepreneurial revolution in the society which will be based on knowledge, which will be based on innovations. And this is possible. We have not tried, therefore we can say we have not achieved enough. But NIF has shown, sir, how this can be done. And we have a model G2G where grassroots innovations have gone to different parts of the world. So there are a lot of cultural creativity which can be a source of entrepreneurship. Bhavi Mahato in Purulia Shodhyatra we found. I have walked 5,000 kilometers, sir, I haven't found a wall like this. The whole wall was beautifully three-dimensional work. Now, we have seen only one such wall of whole heart. She had nothing inside, but she had a desire to be creative. How can we convert her art into entrepreneurship? One wall of every university, I would say, sir, should be dedicated to the folk artists of the region. One wall of every university. Let the art of that region, sir, be celebrated on that wall, and periodically you can invite different artists. One, every day we see that, our mind will be functioning differently. Sir. We will be thinking more creatively, we'll be thinking more empathetically, and something would change in the system, sir. We want, sir, also we have realized that the centenarians, people who live for 100 years, have a tremendous knowledge. Sir, hum log jab kisi ko aashirwad dete hain, to bolte hain 100 saal jiyo. Lekin jab 100 saal ji jata hai koi, to hum uske parwah nahi karte, sir. Very strange. So we have been developing some case studies of centenarians, and we believe that their values and their knowledge can be very powerful driver of future values and society, in society. So these, some of the people in the Ignition Club will go and look at how did they manage with such little. They will talk about climate change. They will talk about different things to these centenarians and get their knowledge into their databases in the knowledge registers. We have licensed some technologies to the companies, and we are trying to prove that mind to market that Dr. Mishalkar was mentioning is a journey that is possible. So these kids, if they will succeed in developing products based on the local knowledge, and some of that will go to market, their confidence will go up enormously, sir. This was knowledge of seven communities, traditional knowledge of seven communities, pooled together, developed a new product. They are invited at the time of launch. A new EDM is being developed, so they will get royalty from these products. A market which is responsible, a market which is responsive, a market which is accountable, that kind of a social market will emerge in society, sir. So, sir, what we're trying to say is that samvedana se srajan shilta, that is the journey that we are trying, sir. Samvedana will emerge when people will go and meet our children, our young people will go and meet the societal talent, will they meet the unrecognized talent of our society. Samvedana ka nirman hoga, sir. Samvedana se srajan shilta jo niklegi, that will be empathetic innovation, sir. That will be innovation which is responsible, which has all the values that you always advocate, sir. So we have exhibitions, sir. Every year we plan to have an exhibition at Rashtrapati Bhavan in Mughal Garden so that common people can come and see. And it's almost like it's also a report to the nation as to what have we discovered new in the last 1 year. So it's a report card of innovation to the society, sir. And we were thinking that there's a book that Madam had seen earlier and suggested that she was feeling that such a book should be given as a gift. So we will modify with your foreword. India Innovates, sir. So we'll rebuild, we will take your message, sir. Yes, sir. And you go somewhere, sir, you can carry this. Yes, sir. We'll rebuild it. And
we'll redesign it and we'll have it hardbound.
And with the message from you, sir.
Just one word. I think this is a great idea. Sir, every year I spend a month in Harvard University as a visiting professor. I teach in Harvard Kennedy School and so on. This interpretation of Gandhi and its significance, his significance in the 21st century, sir, you should just see the kind of impact it has actually. And people are saying that he's more relevant, sir, in the 21st century than he was in the 20th century, sir.